So again, you can open this term for two values, and so on. You continue this up to n terms. So finally, you get inside AB, and then we put the value of AB equal to lambda, and then you can get finally the complete result. First of all, you can start with 2. Suppose n equal to 2. Okay, let's start. For example, suppose n equal to, so A2 and B. So you can write A into A and B. So how you can open this? This is equal to this, and again this is equal to this. So what is the value of AB? Lambda. What is the value of AB? Commutator lambda. So you put it A into lambda plus lambda into A. So you get 2A lambda. It means that 2 lambda A. Okay. If you have the value of A n equal to 2, then you get the final result 2 lambda A. If you have the value of n equal to 3, you get 3 lambda A. If you have the value of n equal to 4, you get 4 lambda A. If you have n is equal to n, then you get n lambda A. You got this point?
लेकिन सर
साहब वो a की पावर n माइनस 1 नहीं आएगा?
हां यस सर. A की पावर भी आनी चाहिए सर.
एंड यस सर, a की पावर ऊपर आनी चाहिए ना, n माइनस 1.
Oh yes, that's good, because here lambda is equal to, you know, n is equal to 2, so you got the value of n is equal to 2 minus 1 equal to 1. So that is the main reason you get lambda ki power equal to 1. But if you have n equal to 3, then you get 2 lambda 2 a, 3 lambda 2 a.
सर ये जो n इज इक्वल टू से ऊपर वाली लाइन में हमने जो वो ओपन किया उसको वो एक दफा सर दोबारा बता दें, ये लास्ट.
ओके लिसन, सो यू कैन ओपन दिस एक्सप्रेशन विद द प्रीवियस एक्सप्रेशन जस्ट लाइक यू आर ना इन द प्रीवियस मेथड. सो इफ यू फील डिफिकल्टी इन दिस मेथड, नो प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन यूज द प्रीवियस वन. प्रीवियस वन इज मोर इजी. सपोज लेट्स सपोज दैट इफ यू कैन पुट इट fn इज इक्वल टू a raised to power n minus b, a raised to power n b, and then so you can open it a n minus 1 into a into b, and then you apply a n minus 1 into a b, and then again plus a n minus 1 into b into a. Okay, so in the first one you put it lambda a raised to power n minus 1, and in the next one you put it a into f of n minus 1. Okay, you get this formula, and then after that you can get the value of, first you get the value of f1. So f1, you can get the value of f1 from here, because f of n is equal to a raised to power n b. So you get 1. It means that a into b, which is equal to lambda. So you have the recursive formula of f of n is equal to lambda a raised to power n minus 1 plus a into f of n minus 1. So you put the value of n equal to 2 here. So f2 is equal to lambda a raised to power 1, no need to write it, 2 minus 1, plus a into f of 2 minus 1. So you get the value of lambda a plus a into f1. So what is the value of f1? F1 is equal to lambda. So you get 2 lambda a. The next one, if n is equal to 3, suppose fn is equal to 3, putting the value in this formula, and then this is equal to 3. It means lambda a raised to power 2 plus a into f of 2. Okay. Again, you can put the value of a f of 2. What is the value of f of 2? F of 2, you can get the value of f of 2 from this equation. So you put 2a lambda or 2 lambda a, it's okay. And then you get lambda a square plus. So you can get the value of 2 lambda.
A square.
2 lambda and lambda a square. So what is the value of 3 lambda a square? Okay. So the next one, if you same case, suppose n is equal to n and so on. So what is the value of f of n is equal to? It means that if there is n is equal to 3, you get 3 here, and then you put it here 3 minus 1. So you can put it n here and lambda a raised to power n minus 1. Okay.
Yes, sir. तो बता हमने इसी तरह सॉल्व किया था ये वाला भी
ठीक है आप जो है ना वो अगर आपको ना ये वाला मेथड इजी लगता है तो यू कैन यूज दिस मेथड बट यू नो दिस इज एन अल्टरनेटिव मेथड सो यू आल्सो यूज दिस अल्टरनेटिव मेथड इफ यू फील सम डिफिकल्टी इन दिस मेथड यू कैन आल्सो अप्लाई दिस मेथड ऑन योर क्वेश्चन बट आई थिंक इफ यू कैन अप्लाई दिस रिलेशन maybe this is the property of commutator if you apply this property you can easily open this one okay move to the next slide so our lecture number 6
excuse me sir
lecture okay
sir assalam alaikum sir
wa alaikum assalam
sir ye aap se puchna tha ki jo humne kal aapne question kaha tha ki let kare ki ah b r hilbert space hai 3 dimensional aur g humne lena tha matrix means ki jisme ek I aur j cat aur bra vector the aur then we have to prove that ki g ka ke sath inner product agar 1 ka liya jaye to wo 1 cat ka liya jaye to wo 2 cat aata hai सर इज इट अ यूनिवर्सल ट्रुथ ये क्योंकि ये नहीं मेरा तो नहीं निकल रहा ये सर ये 2 के इक्वल वो कैट ने
क्या 2
सर जो जी अगर मैं लूं ना आई जे 1 मींस के ब्रा और कैट 1 लूं उसके बेसिस में तो सर मैट्रिक्स जो बनता है और फिर जब बाद में उसको मैं कैट वेक्टर के साथ करूं ना 1 वाले के साथ तो मेरा 2 तो नहीं आंसर आता
Okay, suppose G is our operator, so we are taking G from Hilbert space H to H, okay? So G H is Hilbert space, with standard basis, 1 2 3 so what is 1 actually 1 is equal to this is you know cat 1 so cat 1 is actually this is equal to e1 so what is the value of e1 1 0 0 in three dimensional space. Okay, so what is value of 2? Get 2. This is E2 and this is equal to 0, 1, 0. And what is value of 3? This is equal to E3 and this is equal to 0, 0 and 1. Okay, so we define G from H to H as, suppose G when operate 1, you get the value of 2. When G operate 2, you get the value 1, get 1. When you operate G3, you get, so when you get 1, 2, 2 get 3 and 3 get 1. So this is cyclic. Okay, so this is given, you know, this is given property. So when you apply G on 1, it means that you get 2, it means E2. When you apply 2, you get E3. When you apply G on 3, you get 1. So this is your given property in the question. So you apply this property and then you find the value of G. So what is operator G? What is G? So you think that what is the value of G? If we get the value of G and then we apply that operator on 1 and then you get 2. And then again you apply that operator on 2, do you get 3. When you apply operator G3, G on 3, then you get the value of 1. Okay, so our question is, so I think you are going to apply G on operator 1 and then you did not find the value of 2. I am right?
Excuse me sir, in the last lecture you said that ke 2 jo G hai na hamare paas wo I cat aur J bra ke equal.
Okay, operator is, you prove that operator is defined like this.
Yes sir.
Okay sir, so yes, first of sir. All you think that G is in the form of this. If G is in the form of this, when you are applying G on this, then you get the value of 1 equal to 2 and 2 equal to 3 and 3 equal to 1. So first of all, you find the value of G. So what is operator G? If G is like this, then how you can get the value of this? It means that you can open this. So how you can open this? My question is, agar dekhe hum isko kaise open karenge? Pehla sawal ye hai chale.
Sir, mukhtalif combination se. Means ke I let karke I fix kar le 1, then J will vary J 1, 2, 3.
Theek hai.
There will be different combination. Then fir 2 fix karenge I ko, then J ko vary karenge. Then similarly vice versa, J fix karenge I. I think so this will be the condition.
Any other ji? Okay, I think you can get the value of this 2 and then J1. First of all, you get I equal to 2 and J1. Then in the next plus, you get I3, J2. And the next one, I1 and J3. Because you start from here, first I is equal to 2, 3, 1 and then J 1, 2, 3. So this is operator G. So okay, now you can get the value of this operator first. So what is 1? You have the value of this, you have the value of this and you have the value of this. So okay, 1, 0, 0. And 0, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1. So what is the value of this? 1. What is the value of this? 2. what is the value of this bra? So you can get bra one value, okay, 100, and then you get this value 010, and then you get value 001. So what is the multiplication of this with this? It means that 2 multiply with 1. So you get, because 2 multiply by this 010, and then you 100. So this is 3 cross 1, this is 1 cross 3. Always you got 3 cross 3. So this is 000, and then you can get 100, and then you can get 0010. In the next step, okay, if you take value of 3 with 2, so what is value of 3? 001, and then this is bra 010, and again you get 3 cross 3, 000, 000, and again 010. And what is next one? This equal to this. So you get 100 and then 001. So what is the value of this? 1001 and then 000000. So finally, what is value of G? G is equal to, okay, 000100 and 000. Finally, add up this 000000 and 010. Again, the next 001000000. So these are the same order matrices. So you can add up. In the first, you get only 001. In the next, you get only 100. And the last one, you got 010. So this is the value of G. So when you operate this G, okay, let's check. When you operate this G, okay, this is our G. G is equal to 001. This is in the form of matrix, operator in the form of matrix. So, okay, when you apply G on 1, so what is the value of G? G is equal to 001100010, and then apply on 1. Okay, because this is order 3 cross 3 and this is 3 cross 1. So you can easily multiply, and the resultant is 3 cross 1. So what is the value of resultant? So you multiply this one with this. So you got the value 0. Okay, when you multiply this one with this, you got 1. And then you multiply with this, you get 0. So this is equal to 2. Okay, so now we have done this proof, because when you operate G on 1, you get the value 2. Similarly, when you apply G on 2, so what you get? 001100010. Again, you apply on 2, 010. So what is your point? Okay, suppose multiply by this one, you get 0, and multiply by this one with this, you get again 0. Multiply by this one with this, you get 1. So this is actually 3. Again, you operate on 3. So 001100010, and again operate 001. So what you get? This is equal to, multiply by with this, you get 1, and the 00. So this is this is 1. Okay, so finally, in the case of हिल्बर्ट स्पेस विद थ्री डायमेंशनल हिल्बर्ट स्पेस, यू हैव द बेसिस वेक्टर ए कैट वन कैट टू कैट थ्री एंड देन यू कैन इजीली प्रूव दैट. So when you applying G on one cat one, you can get cat two. When you apply G on cat two, you get cat three. And then you apply G on cat three, you get cat one. Okay, G?
Yes, sir.
अब आपको बात समझ आई है ना?
Yes, sir.
देखें एक चीज होती है ये जो जी जी पूछे
सर, जिधर आपने जी का ये फार्मूला ओपन किया था इनर प्रोडक्ट में आई कामा जे, तो उधर सर आपने टू से स्टार्ट क्यों किया था, वन से भी तो कर सकते हैं, ये भी तो कॉम्बिनेशन मान सकते हैं ना.
वो देखें बेटा, अगर आप उसको ना वन से करेंगे ना, तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि ये जो हमारे पास आपको या ना स्टैंडर्ड बेसिस दिए हुए हैं, इनकी कंपोजिशन ऐसी है वो जब मल्टीप्लाई होंगे ना वो जीरो दे देगा हमें. ठीक है, तो आप देखेंगे कि आपके जो पॉसिबल जो है ना, पॉसिबल जो है ना वो यही बनेंगे. आगे समझ बात?
यस
सर.
तो ये मैंने ना आपके लिए थोड़ा सा इजी कर दिया. इट मीन यू कैन, मतलब है इजीली जो है ना, आप देखें यहाँ से हम एक जनरल जो है ना ओपिनियन बन जाता है ना हमारा, कि अगर फर्ज कर लें आप इसको जो है ना थ्री के लिए ओपन करते हैं तो स्टार्ट कैसे होगा. यानी आप देखें यहाँ से स्टार्ट ज़रा समझ लें अच्छी तरह. ये एक जो है ना जनरल आपके पास फार्मूला बन जाता है ना, कि ये आपके पास देखें वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम टू थ्री वन एंड देन हेयर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्रा वन. ओके, वन इज सो इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्रा वन टू थ्री. इसमें जो है ना आप टू थ्री वन की तरफ चलेंगे और इसमें क्या चलेंगे, वन टू थ्री. यानी ये वाला जो आपका आपके यहाँ पे ब्रा है ना, वो वन टू थ्री तरतीब से चलेगा और यहाँ पे तरतीब चलेगी टू थ्री वन. अब सपोज इसी को हम एक्सटेंड करते हैं, तो आप में से कौन मुझे बताएगा फॉर एन इक्वल टू फोर के लिए हम करना चाहते हैं जी. फॉर एन इक्वल टू फोर इट मीन्स दैट यू गेट ई वन, यू गेट ई टू एंड यू गेट ई थ्री and you get E4. So what is, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, bra or cat, this is 4. So what is the value of this one? This one is 1, 0, 0, 0. What is the value of this one? 0, 1, 0, 0. And what is the value of this one? 0, 0, 1, 0. And what is the value of this one? 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay? So what is G? So in this case G is equal to, you start from here, okay, one, you start from here and then you can start from, in the previous case you start from two because you have three, okay, and three and then three and then again
Four,
and then
one,
what is next? One, sir. One for the last
two. Four, two aayega. One, two, three, and then last one, one or four. Because you have the value of G like this one. When G operate on 1, you get value 2. When you operate G on 2, you get value 3. When operate G on 3, you get value 4. When you operate G on 4, you get 1. Cyclic, hai na? Look like cyclic. So this is our, you know, 3, 4, 2, 1. Okay? In the form of you can open the G like this one. It means first, if you have four dimensional Hilbert space, you start from n minus 1. It means 1, n minus 1 means 3. 4 minus 1, 3. 3, 4, 2, 1. Reverse order. 3, 4, 2, 1. 3, 4, 2, 1. And then here 1, 2, 3, 4.
Excuse me, sir.
Okay.
सर जब हम इधर साइक्लिक परम्यूटेशन ले रहे हैं तो फिर 4 के बाद 2 क्यों लिया, फिर 4 के बाद 1 आना चाहिए ना, फिर 2 आना चाहिए, तो इस तरह तो एंटी
साइक्लिक परम्यूटेशन जो है ना, मैं ये आपको जी की बता रहा हूँ, जी की जो है ना कंपोजिशन इस तरह है कि जी ऑपरेटर जब 1 पे ऑपरेट होता है 2 देता है, जब 2 पे ऑपरेट होता है 3 देता है, 3 पे ऑपरेट होता है 4 देता है, अब जब इसी तरह 4 पे ऑपरेट होगा तो फिर क्या देगा, फिर 1 देगा ना, जो फर्स्ट वाला है वो लास्ट में आ जाएगा। लेकिन यहाँ पे जब इसको ओपन किया है ना तो इसको हमने तो ओपन करना है, सो मेनी टर्म्स आएंगी इसमें, देर आर सेवरल कॉम्बिनेशन होंगे। मैंने तो आपको सिंप्लिसिटी के लिए बताया कि हाउ यू कैन गेट 4 टर्म्स हेयर, 1 2 3 4, सो हाउ यू कैन गेट द 4 टर्म्स हेयर।
फिर जी का साइक्लिक होना जरूरी नहीं है इधर,
नो जी, इट मीन दैट व्हेन यू अप्लाई जी ऑन दिस ऑपरेटर, इट मीन जी एज ए ऑपरेटर वर्क ऑन दिस 1, इट मीन 1 एज ए कैट, सो यू गेट 2 कैट, देन अप्लाई 2 कैट एंड देन यू गेट 3 कैट, देन अप्लाई 3 कैट यू गेट 4, देन अप्लाई 4 यू गेट 1, इन हेयर इन दिस सेंस इट इज लुक लाइक साइक्लिक, इट मीन्स दैट कि साइकिल रिपीट हो रहा है ना, लेकिन डज नॉट मीन दैट कि दिस इज अगेन साइक्लिक। सो So our first question, we already solved this question for n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4. So you apply this for n is equal to n. So the next one is part B, express g square in terms of operator, okay, in this operator. So also you express g square in terms of this. So it means that you got the value of g already here, and then you g square mean g into g. So you multiply by matrix G with G, and then you get the product of G square, and then you finally got in the case of n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, and similarly for n is equal to n. The next one, if A equal to this one, if A operator A is in the form of this, express A G in terms of this. It means that you have the value of A here, and you also got the value of g here also, then multiplying a with g you get the value of ag. Similarly, if in the fourth part g has an eigen value 1, express the corresponding eigen vector in terms of basis vector. Okay, so this one, the fourth part, you have the value of g equal to 1, it means that lambda equal to 1, then you can express g, you can also find the eigen vector also for eigen value lambda equal to 1. If the above Hilbert space correspond to some physical system, then which of the following can be operate, or which of the following cannot be operators correspond to a physical observer. So you also check this one, value of operator B, and again value of operator C, and then you can find the value of operator D. So you can also calculate these two, or you can do yourself. The next one. So next one, we are going to discuss about Pauli matrices. Pauli is another scientist, and then with the name of that scientist, we know that these are the Pauli matrices. So what are the Pauli matrices? The Pauli matrices are 2×2 matrices, which form the basis of vector space of 2×2 traceless Hermitian matrices. So this Pauli matrices are the basis vectors of 2×2 Hilbert traceless Hilbert space, or Hermitian matrices, sorry, and 2×2. They are denoted by sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. So what is the composition of sigma 1? Sigma 1 is equal to 0, 1, 1, 0. And then sigma 2 is equal to 0 minus iota, iota 0. And then sigma 3 is equal to 1, 0, 0, minus 1. you always remember these matrices, these are the polymatrices, and then these have the fixed values. So you know that what is the value of sigma 1, what is the value of sigma 2, what is the value of sigma 3. Just like in the identity matrix, we have the value in the diagonal 1, 1 and non-diagonal 0, 0. Okay. Prove the following properties of polymatrices. Or now you are going to prove the polymatrices properties of polymatrices. Suppose in the first case, sigma a square equal to 1. It means that when you put the value of a equal to 1, 2, 3, because there are three polymatrices, so you can take the value of a 1, 2, 3. The next one in the next part, sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. If you multiply these three matrices, you can get the value equal to iota. And the again one in the commutator form, sigma a over 2 and sigma b over 2 in the commutator form, you can get equal value, get the value equal to iota epsilon abc. Epsilon abc, this is the alternative tensor. It means Levi-Civita tensor of order 3. So into sigma c2, sigma c2. It means that if C equal to 1, sigma 1, C2, sigma 2, C3, sigma 3, because here you are using summation convention, if because C is repeated. The next one, if sigma A, sigma B equal to 2 times delta AB. The third one is when you multiply sigma A, sigma B, you get the value of delta AB plus eta epsilon AB into sigma C. So the next one in the F, n dot sigma whole square. Okay, if n is taking dot product with sigma, then you get n dot n. So you have to prove that how you can get the value of n dot sigma whole square, which is equal to n dot n. The next one is n dot sigma into m dot sigma. If you multiply n dot sigma into m dot sigma, you get the expression n dot m plus iota sigma dot n cross m. The next one is e raised to power iota n dot sigma. Then you get the value of cos in the angle of modulus value of n plus iota n dot sigma over m mod n, and then sine into mod n. So these are how many cases? These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8. There are 8 cases, so you can also prove these 8 cases one by one. So in the first case, how you can prove this? We are going to prove the first one. This is A. So you can take, first of all, you take the value of A equal to 1, then you get it sigma 1 whole square, which is equal to sigma 1 dot sigma 1, sigma 1 into sigma 1. Then what is the value of sigma 1? Sigma 1 is also equal to 0, 1, 1, 0, because this is first polymatrix. So, and then again 0, 1, 1, 0, and then you multiply these two matrices, 2 cross 2 matrices, you again get the value of 2 cross 2. So you find the value equal to 1, because that is identity matrix, so you can write it in the form of 1. Next one is sigma 2 square. Sigma 2 square means sigma square, sigma 2 into sigma 2. So you get the value again equal to 1. And the next one is sigma 3 square. Again, you get the value of equal to 1. So finally, you say that if we get A equal to 1, A equal to 2, A equal to 3, you get the same value. It means that sigma A square equal to 1. So finally, we prove this result A. The next one. So how you prove this one? Okay, you can do it it's very simple B part, because you can multiply sigma 1 with sigma 2, you can get the resultant. That resultant you can multiply with sigma 3, then you can get iota. The next one, okay, we are going to prove this one, third part. Sigma A over 2, sigma B over 2 in the form of commutator equal to 1 over 4. Okay, you can open this. Because this is 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. You're taking 1 by 2 from here outside, 1 by 2 from here outside, you can get outside 1 by 4. So you can open this one, sigma a sigma b. So how you can open sigma a sigma b in the form of commutator? In the previous lecture we have already got the commutator property that if a and b commutator a and b, then you can get a b minus b a. So similarly we are applying the property, same property here, then sigma a sigma b minus sigma b sigma a. Okay, you don't mix this bracket with this bracket. Okay, this is just only simple bracket. So again 1/4, and then you put the value of sigma a sigma b and sigma b sigma a. Suppose that you can get suppose a equal to 1 and then b equal to 2. First, suppose you that a equal to 1, b equal to 2. Then you can get this relation, and this relation. Okay, 1/4 outside, and then iota 0, 0 minus iota 0, 0 iota, and then, okay. So you can, after subtracting these two matrices, you get this result, and then you can taking two iota outside because these are two non-diagonal elements are zero. So taking outside, you get only 1, 0, 0, minus 1. And then finally, you can take iota by 2 and then 1, 0, 0, minus 1. And then you express this in the form of, because if you take minus 1 outside, so what you get the value? What is the value of it means that you put it a here 1 and b here 2, then you get the value of c equal to 3. So what is 3? What is 3? Okay, this is 3. In the case of sigma 3, you are taking the value, when you are taking the value, this is actually the value of sigma 3. Okay, this is the value of sigma 3, and you know that what is the what is the value of epsilon abc, because epsilon abc in the form of cyclic rotation 1 2 3. Okay, epsilon 1 2 3 equal to 1, and then you know that this is very well known cyclic rotation. So you get 1 1 is also, you can write 1 in the form of epsilon abc and then sigma c over 2. So you can prove this result for a equal to 1, b equal to 2, and sigma equal to c equal to 3. Similarly, when you can also replace the different values of a and b, and then you can get the same result again also here. So next one, so h is equal to, okay, suppose you have h equal to like this one. Okay, you also prove these properties again yourself. You do yourself. Next, we are moving on this property. Okay, h is equal to n not 1 plus n dot sigma. So n dot sigma is equal to, what is n dot sigma? N is equal to n1, n2, n3. So sigma is equal to sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. So these, multiplying these two vectors, you get n1 into sigma 1, n2 into sigma 2, n3 into sigma 3. So again, you get n1, and then sigma, put the value of sigma 1 here, put the value of sigma 2 here, then put the value of sigma 3 here, and then you multiply n1 inside, n2 inside, n3 inside, and then you can also add up these three matrices, and then you get this final result, this one. And in the next slide, so again you can take n dot sigma whole square. So n dot sigma whole square, you can prove easily. Okay, n square. So how you can open this? Because n dot sigma whole square equal to n square. So n dot sigma whole square, you also got the value of n dot sigma here. So this is the value of n dot sigma, and then you can take multiplication of this, you know, 2 cross 2 matrix with same self multiplication, and then you get n dot sigma whole square, because n dot sigma whole square is equal to n dot sigma into n dot sigma. So this is n dot sigma, this is again n dot sigma. You multiply these two matrices 2 cross 2, you can get the resultant is also 2 cross 2. So you got the value of resultant here, and then you taking, okay, you can put this equal to n square, and then or similarly you can take n outside, n square is outside, you get identity matrix here, and then finally you get the value of n square. You got this point? And the next one. So n dot sigma into n dot m dot sigma. N dot sigma into m dot sigma is equal to n dot m plus eta sigma dot n cross m. So how you get this relation? Suppose n is equal to this, sigma is equal to this, then n dot sigma you already got in the previous part, you get the value of n dot sigma here. Similarly, you put it m dot sigma, you just replace only n with m. And then the next one, you can take left hand side. So this is the left hand side of above expression, this one. Okay, first of all, you take n dot m. So in the left hand side, you take only n dot sigma, m dot sigma. Okay, you multiply these two matrices. And then after, simplification, lengthy process, okay, but not so much complicated. So you can easily got this value. Okay, you got this value because this one, and this one, because here is sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. Okay, now in the right hand side, you get the value of n dot m. So multiplying this n with m, and then you get this value again, n cross m. N cross m, you can take the value of n cross m. How you can take? Because these are the standard bases 1, 2, 3. These are like I, J, K. Yeah, E1, E2, E3. So here you put N1, N2, N3, M1, M2, M3, and then you're taking the cross product, and this is well-known property. You know that how you can open the cross product. When you open the cross product, you got this relation, and after simplification, you get this one and this one. Okay, then you multiply this one N cross M with iota sigma. If you multiply eta sigma, then you get eta sigma 1, sigma 2, and sigma 3. So this is sigma 1, this is sigma 2, this is sigma 3. So again, because this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, you multiply by this. This is standard basis, you multiply by with sigma 1. You got sigma 1, you multiply by with this, you got sigma 2, you multiply by with this, we got sigma 3. So because you put the value of sigma here, 1 sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. Then again, you can add up this term with this term, and you get this expression, and then finally you observe that left hand side must be equal to right hand side. So you have to prove this.